Up your mouth. Come on. You gotta say something. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, say something. Say something. Hey. Open up your mouth. You gotta put something in your mouth. You gotta say something. Let's go. Say something. Say something. Your mouth. Hey, say something, say something, say. Come on, say something. Now, you gotta give it up. You can't just clap your hands. This one got us in trouble right here. These little interludes got us in trouble. Hey, where my old school at? Where my old school at? If you 37 and above, you old school. Just keep that bass line going. Hey, open your mouth. Come on, son, let's go. You gotta open up your mouth. Give them the fruit of your lips. Hey, say something. Say something. Open up your mouth. Clapping is good, but you gotta get the word out. Get the word out. It's the word. It's the word.
Oh, yeah. You got to open your mouth and say something. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. I will make my boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Open your mouth and say something. Amen. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. We are so glad to be here. This is day two of our word for the week, and our word for the week is openness. Openness. And not only this week is the first week of Advent. Advent, those that celebrate, because the Christian calendar and others, there is just a cycle: winter, fall, spring, summer. There, you know, and so we are now in the season. Last week was Thanksgiving, and that brings us right into the season of Advent, leading up to Christmas. All right, and so the word for Advent, if we had been in our local congregations, those that celebrate Advent, you would have lit the first candle for Advent on Sunday, which is the candle of hope, okay? And so you got to be open to the hope of Jesus Christ that's in you. And so our word for this week is openness. And so, from the Wikipedia, and as I said, I'm not trying to reinvent the wheel. This is a free encyclopedia. These are not my words. This is my resources, and I give you my resources that I get this information from. And so we're gonna go right into our chunk and chew. Okay, we're going to go right into our chunk and chew for today. Openness is an overarching concept or philosophy that is characterized by an emphasis on transparency and cooperation. Okay. Collaboration, where you work on a project together. And right here in the middle is the actual definition that I want us to really focus on and to put in our spirit when we're talking about oneness. And that is, openness refers to accessibility to knowledge. Okay. That means everybody has access to getting the knowledge. Technology, especially in this virtual world that we're living in, every person needs access to technology, our kids and other resources. So first of all, accessibility of knowledge, technology, and other resources is open. That means there's no limitations, there's no barriers. If we go back to Webster Dictionary, we see the transparency of action. That means transparency of action, things that takes place, everyone knows what the action is. When you do any type of teaching or anything, you want to have an action plan, and that is transparency, okay? The transparency of action, whatever I'm going to do is transparent. It's not done in the dark. It's not a secret. And the inclusiveness of participation, all are included. Okay, so we have to be accessible. And so right now we know that even in our spiritual sense, that James tells us that if anyone lack knowledge, let him ask of God, who give liberally and upbraid it not. And it also tells us that the Holy Spirit is here to reveal those things of God that we didn't know. Okay, I have not seen, ear have not heard, neither has it entered into the heart of man the things that God has prepared for them that love him. But God has revealed. Okay. And I need that scripture. Okay. God has revealed. We need that scripture. I may have it later in the week. But I think I can find it real quick. I want that scripture. I think I have it coming up. Actually, I don't have it coming, but I want to find it. First Corinthians 2 and 9. First Corinthians 2. And that openness can be said to be the opposite of closeness, central authority, secrecy. Okay, there was some things that God, the mysteries of God, the secrets of God, but he is revealing it now. 1 Corinthians 2 and 9, it just came to me, and I'm going to write it down. I'm going to have to put it in here. 1 Corinthians 2, okay, there it is. But God have revealed. This is the thing that we want. And we're going to talk about this on Friday. I'm going to put this down. This is going to be one of 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 9-12. But as it is written, I have not seen nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God hath prepared for them that love him. And most of the time they stop right there. Okay. But God hath revealed them unto us by his Spirit. He has opened them up to us. He has exposed us to that. For the Spirit searches all things, yea, the deep things of God. For what man knoweth the things of a man, save the spirit of the man, which is in him? Even so, the things of God knoweth no man but the Spirit of God. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God. The openness of God the transparency, the accessibility of knowledge. We all have access to this knowledge. And God is being very transparent in the scriptures, and it's inclusive that all may participate. Oh, let me put this right here. Okay, so that's going to be something else I'm going to do. I'm going to add to, I'm not sure what all I have on Friday. I know I didn't have this on for Friday, but I'm going to add that to Friday's notes. All right. So, an openness, and there's all classifications of openness. It talks about openness in government applies to the idea of freedom of information, to information held by authorities and holds that citizens should have the right to see the operations and activities of government at work. So if you work for a government agent, there are so many, a lot of those records are open to the public, okay? That it's not hidden, that it's transparent what the rules and the regulations are, the policies and procedures, that's open. And it's free information. You don't have to pay for it. And so you have to be careful, because a lot of your information that you have is free and open to the public. It becomes public information, okay? If you have an arrest record, some legal different stuff going on, anybody can put your name in there and find out stuff about you. Public record, legal record, open record, government. Open education refers to institutional practices and programmatic initiatives that broadens access to the learning and training traditionally offered through formal education systems. So it eliminates the barriers of entry. It's open education, okay? And so we usually call this open education, that's what we pay for, state and federal funds. It's not private education. Okay, it's open to anyone, okay? Open access refers to the practice of allowing peer review research articles to be available online free of charge and free of most copyright and license restrictions. It's used to further the education and to just get feedback and for the study. And so you have open access. That means anyone that have the credentials or have the right passwords or whatever, or have been given the link or whatever, is open. In psychology, openness to experience is one of the domains which are used to describe human personality in the five-factor model. And we're going to talk a little bit about the five-factor model tomorrow and a little bit going into Thursday. So Wednesday and Thursday, we're going to talk a little bit. I'm going to present it to you. I'm going to give you some chunks and chew on this five-factor model. And I'll tell you what that consists of. Okay, we're going to look at this, like I said, later in the week. Tomorrow, we're going to look at openness, and I had put this for tomorrow. I should change the slide, okay? Because we're actually going to talk about that today. I'm just going to give you a little chunk to chew on. We're going to talk about it briefly on Wednesday, but mostly we're going to get into this five-factor model Wednesday into Thursday, and we got some more scriptures. And then the Spirit just gave me this passage of scripture that we're going to talk about a little bit more. Actually, that's probably going to be our key verse. All right. I was looking at this other monitor, seeing what's coming up. Okay. All right. So while I was studying openness and pulling resources together, looking in the Bible, pulling some scriptures and researching some of them to bring into, because we're talking about the topic that we're talking about, because a lot of times when you preach, you have a text and you have a topic. And some time you exegete that text, you'll walk down it line by line. But sometimes you pull a thought out of it and you build your scripture and you build your presentation based on that thought or that topic that you have pulled to teach or preach on. And so I pulled the topic being openness, and then I go and research and pull everything that talks about, you know, so you'll Google the word open and you'll Google the word openness. You'll look at the synonyms. What other words mean the same thing when you talk about openness, reveal, exposure? And so you begin to pull those things. And while I was pulling that, I came across this theology. I don't know a lot about it. I didn't dig down in it because I know that I'm not going to believe it because the basics of it goes against what I believe to be true about God, Jehovah, God, the all-wise Yahweh. And so I believe that he's omnipresent. I believe that he's omniscient. I believe that he's omniscient. I believe that he's all-knowing, all-powerful, and ever-present. Okay. And so in this open theism is also known as open theology, and free will theism is a theological movement that has developed within Christianity as a rejection to the synthesis of Greek theology and Christian theology, okay? Philosophy and Christian theology, okay? It denies the orthodox doctrine of God being all-knowing, okay? God is all knowing. And so this theory or this theology, this study, because it says if God is all knowing, it comes in conflict with man being able to have free will. Because if God knows what you're going to do, then you don't really have free will. That's what they try to say. Okay. And so oftentimes you need to know what other people believe. So you'll know what not coming against it. I'm not trying to teach nobody what you believe. You believe what you believe. I believe that God is all knowing. I believe he's all powerful, and I believe that he's ever present. Okay. And whether he has foreknowledge, whether he knows what's going to happen, and he has given us free will, just because he knows what choices we're going to make does not mean that he it's wrong for him to have foreknowledge, because he don't try to alter the situation of our choices, nor does he steps in when we make choices that we should not make that cause harm and havoc in the earth. But they say that, you know, this would be logically inconsistent. Okay, so this particular theory, if you look it up, if you have someone talking to you about openness theology and free will theism, is a theological movement within Christianity, because some believe certain things based on it. You can find enough scripture to support it. And then it gives a spin on it because they do believe that God is God, Jehovah. They do believe that he's, you know, he has all power, but they do not believe that he's all knowing, and they don't believe that he's present everywhere. Okay. So this particular theory denies the belief that God knows all things exhaustively before they happen. Okay. And that it denies that God even knows what choices we're going to make. It is based on this logically inconsistent to say that God knows in advance what someone would freely do in a libertarian sense. Okay. So in a sense, you know, and so, but this is what we believe. So we have to learn to stand on what we believe the truth is for us. And so standing firm on what I believe, scripture affirms that God's knowledge of himself and of the world is exhaustive. God is our Lord and great and abundant in power. His understanding is beyond measure. Okay. Great is our God. Great is our Lord. I'm looking at it and still reading something different. Great is our Lord and abundant in power. His understanding is beyond measure. Okay. Peter said to Jesus, Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you. Jesus said to him, feed my sheep. Okay. And this is when Jesus was talking to Peter after he rose from the dead. You know, and Jesus was telling him, saying, Peter said, I love you more than everybody. And so Jesus said, feed my sheep. Feed. First John 4, whenever our hearts condemn us, God is greater than our heart. And he knows everything. Okay. And so it's good that God is greater than our heart, because sometimes we will be still stuck in a place of low self-esteem because the things that our minds from our heart would condemn us. But God is greater than that, because he knows everything. He knows our ability. And so if someone comes, or you've been dealing with that theory, I'm just saying, God knows everything. God is all-knowing. You open your mind. God knows everything because he is the Lord of all. He made the heavens and the earth, and he knows his plan for his history. He controls over all things. He has control over all things. His judgments of truth have ultimate authority. And in his presence, everything is observed what is happening. Okay. And so I want you to read these verses of scripture. God is all knowing. And he wants to be open our mind to knowing that God knows all things, but he has given us free will even in that knowing all things. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 11, Romans 11, verse 13, John chapter 17, verse 17, and the whole Psalms 139. Okay. Once again, this is L.F. Craig, Ambassador Craig of the Shelter God Safe House, and In the Know for New Life. Get in the know today, and you can change your every tomorrow. Yes, you are fruited and gifted. Pull your gift out, share it with the world. This is my chunk and chew for this Tuesday, the first day of December 2020. So I want you to chew on this. I want you to chew on this that I have given you. Just think about it. Just go back and replay it and listen to it. All right. Click like and click share. Share it with others. If you have any questions, you can inbox me. I'll be glad to dialogue with you. You can inbox me if we're Facebook friends. If not, you can put a post on here and I will respond on here. So be blessed, my brothers and my sisters. Have a good rest of your day.
What's up, family? It's time to worship a risen Savior. His name is Jesus. Wherever you are, I need you to clap your hands like this. Come on. If you are ready to experience his presence in your homes, in your apartments, in your cars, if you're watching at work, I need you to clap those hands and begin to give Jesus praise. Everybody clap your hands. Father, we want you today. You and only you, have your way in our spaces today. Invade our spaces like only you can. We love you, Jesus. Come on, let's raise this to our Father.
Just open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart, 'cause I want to see you.
Yeah.
I want to see you.
that's our heart today. Just open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart, 'cause I wanna see you. Oh, I wanna see you. Can we raise that together? Come on, every voice, tell them. Say, open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Come on, sing it to Jesus.
Open the eyes of my heart.
Say, I wanna see you, oh God, like never before, Jesus. God, if we've ever needed you before, it's right now. Come on, sing it again. Say, open the eyes.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord.
Come on, if you need him, come on, open your mouth and tell him. See, I want to see you. Come on, just see you high and lift it up. Shining in the light of your glory. Come on, somebody ask him today. Say, God, pour in my home, pour in my family, pour today. Come on, say it again.
To see you high.
We need you to pour today.
Pour out your power
as we cry out with the angels. Y'all ready? Everybody, put your hands up. I need some worshipers. I need some praises who don't mind standing up in your living room and letting God know that I come to bless you. I showed up to give you glory. You've been too good for me to sit down and be passive today. I need some worshipers. Triple your feet. Everybody give God praise. Jesus, pray. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us. Oh, come on, let's raise it again. Say, open the eyes. The chaos, God, I need you to open the eyes.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord.
Give us heaven's view
open
today.
Open the eyes of my heart.
Oh, I want to see you. Oh, see, I want to. We got to go. Can you raise this with us? To see you. Father, we lift you up right now. You said if I'll be lifted up, that I would draw. So draw today.
Oh.
As we say, we agree with the angels. Come on, cry out.
To see you high lifted up, shining in the light. Yeah.
Oh God, we need you to pour out. Person watching today. That's it. To every person that's watching, that's in the valley of decisions, God, will you open the eyes of their hearts, God? Woo. Just open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart, 'cause I need to see you. Woo. Stay right there. I want to see you. Say, I want to see you. I want to see you. If we've ever needed you before, we need you right now. And I want to see you. Come on, team, raise that with us. Say, I want to see you. Oh, I don't care where you're watching from. I need you to lift those hands and just close your eyes and tell them, I want to see you. For my family today,
I want to see
for my business today,
I want to see.
I got some loved ones that need you today. Oh Lord, say I wanna. In the midst of the chaos, God, ever. In the midst of the chaos, God, oh God. In the midst of the chaos, God, would you speak clearly, Shekeba? Would you speak clearly today? Would you speak clearly? Cause I wanna see. If you need him, come on, ask him today.
I want to see.
We need you. We need you. We need
I
you.
See.
We need you. Say, I want
to see you. I want
to
see you.
Oh God, we're desperate today.
I want to see you.
Oh, see,
I want to see you.
You got 30 seconds. I just need you to worship him because he's here.